rulings out is in 3 points. So brothers, we have to give the attention to what the Shaykh said. Shaykh's leaving, but we still have to focus on what the Shaykh said, otherwise we won't take the final benefits what the Shaykh gave to us. Number one, respecting the scholars and the fuqaha and giving them honor and putting them in their proper position. Number two, taking from all of the scholars and not just limiting ourselves to one scholar rather than the other. Sheikh said, imagine I have a beautiful garden with many trees and different kind of fruits, and I only ever eat from one tree, and I only ever eat from one fruit. So he said like this, the scholars, the fuqaha, we take from all of them, and we don't just take only from one of them. The third thing he said is that we give precedence and honor to the evidences, but not independently of the explanation of the scholars and their fiqh and their extraction of rulings and their opinions. He said, it's not allowed for us to do that. It's not allowed for us to just take a text and ignore all the scholars. But we honor the evidences more, while we'd say that we don't take those evidences independently of what the scholars said. And he quoted from Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah ta'ala, beware of every issue in which you don't have an imam, i.e. you don't have someone who came before you that held that opinion. And he said that Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala used to repeat this again and again and again. Beware of every issue, yani every opinion you give in which you don't have an imam, you don't have someone before you. And he said this is the methodology of Ahlul Hadith. And the Shaykh said this is something that shows us from Shaykh Al-Albani, that what people say about Shaykh Al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala, that Shaykh Al-Albani used to give opinions that he didn't have a precedent, or used to give straight from the Hadith and not look at what the scholars say, then why is it that Shaykh Al-Albani is always repeating, keep away from every issue that you don't have, or beware of every issue where you don't have someone who said it before you, someone that you're copying before you. So he said this is the methodology of the scholars of Hadith, the ones who came before, the ones who came after. They don't say anything different. They say the same thing as that. He said, but I will repeat that they are human beings who make mistakes and they get things right. He says, sometimes we say the Hanafis were wrong about this, the Shafi'is were wrong about this, or we say Abu Hanifa was wrong about this. We say Sheikh Al-Albani was wrong about this, or Sheikh bin Baz was wrong about this, or Sheikh bin Uthaymeen, Rahim Allahu al-Jami', may Allah have mercy on them, always wrong about this. He said, we don't find that like, that's no haraj for us. That's nothing like, it's not something that's hard for us to say that somebody made a mistake. But he said, the matter comes back to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that if the person who is judging makes his best effort and gets it right, then he has two rewards. And if he makes his best effort and he gets it wrong, he has one reward. And the Shaykh concluded by saying, this is for the hakim, the judge, the scholar. We're not talking about the ignorant people picking and choosing random ideas like that, and they just picking any idea they want and just going with it, and they're going to get one reward or two. But we're talking about the scholars, the ulama. We're not talking about the juhala, the ignorant people. The scholar, when they make their best efforts in something and they got it right, they get two rewards. And when they make their best effort in something and they're qualified to do that and they don't get it right, then they get one reward. And that's the conclusion, to the best of my ability, of what the Shaykh said. Hafidhahullah ta'ala.